the Lord. Hallelujah. God is good. And I welcome you all in the house of God. And God bless you all, whoever listened in this, in the YouTube, in the Facebook. And today I want to share the gospel. I want to share the good news to everyone. And I want to share the word of God to everyone. And whoever's hear my voice, the Lord is going to bless you all. And the Lord is going to change your life. The Lord is going to touch your life today. Amen. And today I want to bring the topic, under the topic of knowing the truth, rejecting the fall, or accepting the truth, rejecting lie. So this is the God's word is telling us again. And this passage is taken from the 1 John chapter 5, verse 18 to 21. Verse 18 to 21. 1 John chapter 5, verse 18 to 21. We see in that passage that, you know, the truth comes only God. Only God is the truth. And only God is the truth, and the word of God is the truth. We are living, and then God wants us to live in truthful life. God wants us to live in the truthful life, and God want us to live, come back to the right position. God want us to come back to the life that He want us to live again. Today, the world that we're living, full of lies, full of faulty things, full of things that we have been. You see your own eyes. I see my own eyes, and even we ourselves not truthful to ourselves. Even we ourselves, we deceive ourselves. We, sitting ourselves. We lie ourselves. Then when we see the world that I facing today, I see people today. I experience people today, husband and wife lie one another, parents lie to their children, children lie to their parents, and family lie one another, brother, sister, and in-law, everyone deceive one another, everyone living in the wrong position, everyone living under the lie, everyone living under the sitting and deceiving. Governments alive, society alive, church alive, everywhere there is no truthful, everywhere there is not right, everywhere there is wrong, everywhere there is things happening. That is why God is telling us again. Today I bring you again to transform your life. And today we need to come back again. The Bible, the word of God saying is on that God, whoever born in God, they are in living in truth. But whoever does not, and whoever know God, who they know the understanding of truth, and the truth come from God only, and the word of God is true, and the truth is come only by God himself. But all the lie come from Satan. Today we are living in this world. You see the media are lie, news are lie, everywhere are lie. And today we are living in the life of God, you know, in the pandemic time. We are living in the COVID-19. We are living in the everywhere there is a rumors, and we cannot find what is really COVID-19. Everywhere you see the medicines and this and that, the sickness, nobody can not reveal the truth. Nobody reveal the truth, what kind of really sickness, where it come from. Nobody know till now, blame one another. And all so many things that we are living. And then when we look on, when we are on the TV, everywhere news were lie, nobody speak the truth. But you know, the truth is in us, but we never come out with the truth. And that we know the truth, but we never live in the truth. We deny the truth and we accept the lie. So today I bring unto you all, today I'm sharing unto you all, we need to reject the lie, we need to accept the truth, and we need to remove the fall, and we need to accept the truth. This is how God wants us to live again, so that our life will be saved. Our life will be saved, and our life will be come back to the life that God wants us to create it. You know, the word of God say in the Gospel of John, you know, in this world, in the Gospel of John chapter 5, verse 19, we know that we are of God, and the whole world lie under the sweep away of the wicked one. See, the word of God is warning us. The whole world is living under lie. The whole world is swept away with lie. We see around the world, everywhere is lie, deceiving, sitting, and so many things are happening. We are under there. And the word of God also telling us that we are living under there. So we need to come back. And then I will tell you, you know, the lie. What is the lie? The Bible says in the Gospel of John chapter 8, verse 44, devil is the father of lie. Lie come from Satan. And then when we are living under the lie, there is no success, there is no prosperity, there is no peace, there is no joy. The lie will lead into danger. The lie will lead into the destruction. The lie will lead into hell. The lie will lead into sorrow. The lie will lead into poverty. The lie will lead into a wrong life. The lie will lead into death and eternal death. The lie will lead into wrong direction. But let us come back to the truth. When we walk in the light, when we walk in the truth, when we speak in the truth, that truth will set us free. The Word of God says that the truth will set you free. And also the Word of God says Jesus is the way, the truth, and the light. So when we look in God, when we obedience the Word of God, when we have God, and the truth will set us free. Let us see in the light of, when we see in the light of Joseph. Joseph was living in truthful life. The brother and all, they deceived them, and they are sitting them, they sell them, brother and all, come back to the father, your sons are died, animals are steered away, but they lied to the father. And then Joseph was sitting with the brothers, and Joseph was sold, and Joseph went down to Egypt, and Joseph was, even when he was in Egypt, Potiphar's wife was right to sitting him, and so many things happened, but he never lied. He lived in the truth, and he was putting into prison, and even that in that prison he never lied. He lived in truth. He speak in truth. One day, one night, one morning, Joseph come out from the prison, and he become the governor in Egypt. And then also later on, all the brothers and sisters come back, and the brothers and the parents, the family, they come down to Egypt, and they found out that Joseph was that governor, and they telling like to the father that Joseph was died. The brothers and all. But that day, when they come to realize that Joseph was alive, he was the governor, and Joseph was staying in the truth. Joseph was become the, in the foreign land, he become the governor, and the brothers and sisters who lie, they become so shameful. They become no word to say, and the lie revealed. One day, the truth will reveal to the light, and when the truth come out, the people become same. The people become there, you know, there is no face to hide. The face becomes so same and so become so things. That is the thing. So when you speak light, the truth will reveal. That day we become same. That day we become sorrow. That day we become regretted. Why I did that? Why I telling lie? Why I gossip? Why I kill that person? Why I criticize that person? Why I sitting that person? Why I deceiving that person? When the truth reveal, the lie becomes so same. The lie that we have, and that lie become put us into so degraded in life. That lie, that fall will put us into down, will put us into discouraged, disappointed, anxiety, depression. But when we stand in the truth, you know that? Even though you may be going through challenges, persecution, trials, temptation, people will accuse you, people will deceive you, people will say they will just point finger at you. But when you are standing in the truth, when you are speaking the truth, when you walk in the truth, when you live in the truth, and when you deny the wrong, when you deny the lie, when you deny the wickedness, when you deny the evil thing, when you deny the all kinds of wrong things, when the truth reveals, you will be the top. And God will exalt your name. God will exalt your life. God will exalt your business. God will exalt your study. God will exalt your family. God will exalt your love. Whatever you are doing, your job. But when we are lying, everywhere there is a lie, job a lie, and the you know, people who are doing business a lie, people are studying that they are lie. Everywhere there is a lie. But when you are doing the truth, when you walk in truth, when you speak in truth, when you live in truth, and the truth will set you free, and the truth will leave you high, and the truth will bring you into prosperity, and the truth will bring you into success, and the truth will bring you into joy, and the truth will bring you into victory, and the truth will bring you into you know, the victorious, the glorious life. That is the how God created us. So today, I just want to tell you all, let us reject the fall. Let us reject the lie. The Bible says, rejecting the lie and then accepting the truth. Let us live a life of truthful life, and let us live it. And then the word of God say, you know, the way we live for the truth, the truth will set you free. The truth will you know, bring into God present, and the truth will bring into the kingdom of God. And the person who live in truthful life, that person will inherit the kingdom of God. That person will receive all the blessing of God. That person will receive all the prosperity of God. That person will receive all the success that God has created. They will become successful, they will become prosperity, not only on this earth, they will inherit the kingdom of God. But when you live in life, when you walk in life, when you do your work in life, when you anything that you are doing in life, anything that you are living in life, anything that you are eating in life, anything that you are dressing in life, anything that you are speaking in life, that will lead into eternal death. And that will lead into poverty, that will lead into sorrow, and that will lead into the wicked life. That is why that the Bible says that Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Let us come back to the truth, and let us come back to the word of God. Whoever born in God, they will deny the sin. Whoever born in God, they will live in the truth. You see, and the devil is the father of lies. So that devil, whoever follow the lie, the sitting, the discipline, the gossiping, and working in lie, speaking in lie, living in lie, was doing a job in lie, doing business in lie, the ending will go to hell. That is God doesn't want us. And today, let us come back. Let us deny all the lie. Let us come back to the truth. Let us live a life of truthful life. That is how God wants us to live. And that is how God wants. That is what David said. You know, he said, Lord, lead me in the truth, and your word is the truth. In the Psalm 1 and Psalm 25 verse 5, the Bible said, the Lord, lead me every day in the truth, and your word is the truth, so that I will not commit sin. So our life, let us ask the Lord to lead us into the truth, not to lead into the wrong, not to lead into the fall, not to lead into the lie, so that that lies we will come out. Also said, David said that, you know, he was saying that, Lord, you set out from lie and in the truth. You set me, come and bring me to the light, and take away from the wickedness. And that also he was telling, David was telling. And today we are living in the world that, you know, that lie will never save our life. But truth will only save our life. And truth will only setting us free. Amen. And also the word of God say that, I was just want to read the word of God, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 25. Therefore, having put away falsehood, let each one of you speaking the truth and with his neighbor, and for we are the members of one another. So the word of God is telling us in Ephesians, Paul was telling us, therefore, put away all the fall, speaking in truth one another. And then, for we are the members of one another. We are one another. We are the members of one another. We are one. So let us speak one another with truth. Let us speak one another with truth. And let us take away all the lies and evils and deceiving. And then also the Bible, and then also zones of the 3 verse 18. Little children, let us not love the work of the words, but let us live with the actions of truth, not only by words, but our action. Let us live with the life of truthful, and let us live the life of truthful life. That is God wants us. And also in the first zones of the 5 verse 21, the word of God say, take away all the lie, take away all the idol, take away all the things that is not right, but come back to the truth. And that is God wants us to. And zones of the 14 verse 6 says, Jesus will say, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So when Jesus is the way, follow his way, believe God and trust in God and live in the life of truthfulness, that will lead us into heaven, that will lead us into the kingdom of God. And also in the zones of the 8 verse 32 say that you will be the truth, and the truth will set you free. So truth only, the truth only set us free. Lie will never set us free. Lie will lead us into danger. Lie will lead us into destruction. Only the truth will set us free. Our life, our family, from this COVID-19, and from the life, from your difficulties, challenges, from the life that you're living, only the truth will set us free. My brothers and sisters, today I want to encourage you all. Today the word of God is telling us, rejecting the lie and accepting the truth. And Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And the Word of God says that truth will set you free. Lie will never set you free. Lie will never set you free. Be careful. Lie will set you. Lie will lead into hell. Lie will lead into, you know, sorrow, pain, discouragement, disappointment, shame, and put you down and no prosper, no success. Everything that you do with lie, it will pull you down day by day. It will bring you down day by day. But when you are deep in the truth, that truth will set you free from every problem, set you free from financial, set you free from sickness, set you free from disappointment, set you free from accusation, set you free from deception, set you free from shame, set you free from all kinds of challenges that you are going through. That truth will set you free, because the truth is Jesus. Lie is Satan. Satan will never set us free. Satan will lead us into danger. Satan will lead us into destruction. So when we are living in lie, we belong to Satan. But when we are rejecting the lie, when we are accepting the truth, and truth is Jesus, live for Jesus, live for truth, rejecting the lie, rejecting the fall. Let us live a life of truthful life. And today we are living in the world of full of danger, full of lies, cheating, deceiving, corruption. We look into the king to the bottom, city to the village, outskirt area to the city life, district, everywhere, family, ourselves. And we are living in the life of, in the ends that we are, God is coming soon. But we are living in the life of deceiving and lie. But today let us come back to the living in the truthful life, so that we will inherit the kingdom of God, and you and I are free from every work of the Satan, from hell. We will inherit the gods that who prepare for us. God bless you all, whoever hear my voice. God bless you all. Let us receive. And let us live our life in the truthful life. And God will continue to help us to live in truth. And so that we become the one family of God. So that we all will be inherit the kingdom of God. God is giving us a source of free salvation, eternal life. That He has loving us, He giving to us. And let us have the salvation. Let us have the eternal life. And let us have the family of God. Lie is the family of Satan. That is not from, and that is not our portion. Our portion is the truth, and the truth will set you free. Amen. And God bless you all. And then also I want to tell you all, please, if you are listening to this boy, and if you are seeing, hear my voice, and also you all are just subscribe our YouTube channel. This YouTube channel is the Rehoboth Church Delhi, and we are from Rehoboth Church, we are from Delhi, and subscribe our channel, and so that we will upload every week. And then we will also, so many things we are uploading, not only in preachings and so many songs and activities in the church. And by hearing that, you all are going to bless and share this channel to all your friends and family, so that everyone will be blessed. God bless you all. Have a blessed day and have a blessed week. Amen.